Hey guys, Charles Calloway here, 15 on the scenes. As you guys know, financial advisors, small business owners and their employees, and I absolutely love to listen to, learn new stories of what's going on in the community. I love talking to small business owners. I think they are the heroes of the community, the small business owners. Irene Rivera Brooks, and she just started a business, guys. This name, I want to say this right, No Place Like Home Senior Services. And you're right, No Place Like Home, if you're old enough to remember The Wizard of Oz. Okay, we're going to talk about that a little bit, but I'm so glad you're here.
Thank you for having me.
Come over to my office and everything. It's all messy and stuff.
No, not at all. You should see mine.
Okay. So today is my day of cleanup. I'll use that as my excuse.
Okay, good excuse. So, I'll use it as well.
The last time I saw you, we ran into each other over at a facility over here. It was a senior.
It was an assisted living facility.
And I was over there. I think we were going to, that's right, we were doing some type of workshop there. We were discussing it. And you were meeting with someone over there. And I was like, what are you doing over here? Because you were in advertising when I met you.
Right. Yeah, so I was talking to the seniors. Uh-huh. I like to do little talks, little workshops for them. Uh-huh. But I was in advertising when we met because I was in the process of taking care of my parents who had gotten sick at the same month, same year. Wow. And I quit my job as a social worker. And thank goodness I met the folks over at JNOW.
Okay.
And they said, we don't care when you work, just here are your goals.
Okay.
All right. I was able to balance the two.
All right. So there's probably something that led up to that. Like you said, did I hear you right? You said the same month, both your parents?
Yes. It was within days. My dad ended up in the hospital. He had Alzheimer's, but what got him in the hospital, he had end-stage renal failure. So his kidneys had just failed.
Wow.
And then my mom had congestive heart failure. So she ended up in the hospital same time. And I was working as a social worker at the Department of Social Services.
Okay.
And that was a really demanding job. I was working with families and children.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to take some time off to take care of them because mm-hmm. it was a crazy time. We didn't know what was going to happen.
That had to be crazy. So you just left your job to care for your parents?
I took FMLA. And
what is that?
Family medical leave.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. So you can take up to 12 months unpaid time, and your job is federally protected.
Okay.
But you're not paid.
So this is a government. Okay, government job. Okay.
Well, but it's a law. So any company above, I'm not sure how many employees,
uh-huh.
has to abide by the FMLA. So if I have proof, like I had to bring in paperwork from my parents' doctors saying
right.
that this was going on.
Right.
They have to hold your job. Or a job.
Okay, a job.
Yes,
okay.
For you.
I never heard this before. One of the things about you, you're resourceful. You know how to find and get things done. Were you aware of that role before this all happened to you?
I did. I remember okay. when it first came out, but I didn't understand how important it was.
Or until you had to.
Yeah, because you hear things kind of in the background
okay.
of your life, but when things happen and you have to utilize these things and you realize
mm-hmm.
that they're there to protect you. They're there to help you.
Right.
So I'm grateful for that time.
Right. So this may be a bunny trail, but I want to ask you this. So mm-hmm. how does a person that does social work for a living think that they can be successful doing advertising while caring for parents? How does that happen?
So growing up, uh-huh. I wanted to be a social worker.
Okay.
That's what I wanted to do. I had my heart set on it. And my mom
mm-hmm.
said, no social workers making no money. Social workers are in danger. I grew up in New York City, so it was indeed.
These are true things.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And it was dangerous here too, but okay. You know, less so.
Okay.
And so I went to school for social work, graduated, but then went into the music industry doing marketing and promotions.
You keep me on my toes. Okay, so that's what you studied in school, but you ended up in the music industry?
Yeah. So I used to temp to make extra money while I was in college.
Okay, resourceful guy.
Okay. And so I went on a 1 week long assignment to a record label.
Okay.
And never left. They offered me continued work. So anytime I had breaks, I would work there. When I graduated, I just stayed there. And it was a really good job for a 20 something year old to have.
Right. So then you decide to go into you had to take a cut in pay to go into social work at that point, didn't you?
Oh, huge. Huge.
So this is something you really felt, this is what I'm supposed to be doing.
Yeah. So I went into, when I came here to North Carolina, I went into radio and did radio advertising and marketing.
Okay.
And that was fantastic. Mm-hmm. But then that desire to really help and serve my community mm-hmm. just kept on kind of nudging at me. Mm-hmm. And so I ended up leaving that and going to the Department of Social Services working for with families.
This is all making sense.
Yeah.
The dots are connected. Mm-hmm. All right, so by the time we ran into each other, that was several months ago, you were now, you landed, you decided to start your own business.
I did. While I was taking care of my parents,
right.
My mom got better, my dad didn't. Okay. So I ended up having to do his dialysis treatments at home every day because he didn't want to go to the dialysis center. Mm-hmm. And learning so much about dementia and how it affects entire families. And so I was trying to get resources because, mm-hmm. you know, that's kind of what I do. Mm-hmm. And realized that there really wasn't any one entity that could navigate somebody mm-hmm. through. So I decided to create that. Okay. So I left, you know, I decided that I can do it on my own, but I didn't know the industry. So okay. I worked for a large national franchise mm-hmm. and learned a lot and worked with incredible people. Mm-hmm. And I got to use my social work brain my social work heart mm-hmm. and my marketing brain.
I love
all
that.
In one job.
I love that.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
You know, one of the things, I keep going back to resource, but I don't want to overuse mm-hmm. the term, but you have a way of, you see the problem and you're going to put together the pieces to make it happen, which all kind of leads to your magic skill, I think, in your business mm-hmm. and helping people navigate. And I love that word, navigator. You're a navigator.
Yeah.
For those who are in trouble because of this mm-hmm. and everything. And you said your dad suffered from dementia.
Yes.
So if I read properly, you actually went and got some certifications to be.
I did. Mm-hmm.
So what is that actual certification?
So it's a certified dementia practitioner.
Uh-huh.
And I learned pretty much everything about dementia, and I'm able to help people with dementia and their families mm-hmm. kind of understand, because there's quite a big learning curve. And the thing about dementia is that it manifests itself in different ways with mm-hmm. different people.
Okay.
So you can have somebody that is just really easy and just, you know, well, I'm not sure you're a nice guy, but I'll go with you. Mm-hmm. And then there's some that have a drastic personality change. And that's hard on everyone. Mm-hmm. You know, my dad was an incredibly kind, funny, incredible man. Mm-hmm. In the midst of his dementia, he would yell at my mom. He mm-hmm. would, you know, it was just a whole different person. Now, mm-hmm. I knew that it was his brain, not, you know, anything else. Mm-hmm. But for people that don't know, mm-hmm. you think, you know, this is terrible. I can't, you know, what is he doing? He's being mm-hmm. awful.
Right.
So it's really, so I decided to get that certification so that I can help others mm-hmm. kind of get through this, because it's nothing easy about it.
Right. Wow. Well, guys, isn't this an interesting story? It's so striking. We're going to learn more from Irene about how she ended up doing her business. We want to learn more about her business and how she serves the community and what makes her business special. So we'll see you next time.